I'm going to get the sample standard deviation and sample variance for those 13 values from my last example. So I already have the values inputted into my calculator under my stat and edit list. So there are the 13 values I entered previously. To get the sample standard deviation, I want to press the stat key, right arrow over to calc, and select one variable statistics. This is the same place you went to when you were finding the mean and the median. Again, we want to keep our frequency list blank because we're not finding the mean or the standard deviation or variance for grouped data or a probability distribution, which we'll cover in a future video. All right, so I want to scroll down and select enter. And here's the sample mean that I found previously and some pieces of information, sigma x and sigma x squared. If you were to find variance and standard deviation by hand, those are two useful pieces. But I find it best just to use technology directly because the calculations can be pretty cumbersome. So this first standard deviation is S sub x. I don't know why they put the sub x there, but the S indicates that it is the sample standard deviation. The output for the TI-84 only gives the sample standard deviation and the population standard deviation. It doesn't give the variance, but the relationship between the variance and the standard deviation is that the standard deviation is the square root of the variance. So to get the variance, if you're given standard deviation, all you have to do is take your standard deviation and raise it to the second power. Now to get the best answer, you want to carry out your numbers pretty far. So I'm going to go ahead and round to 5 decimal places after the decimal point, and then go ahead and square it. So that standard deviation rounded to 5 decimal places is 1.73944. And I want to raise that to the second power, so I'm going to press on this x squared key and then press enter. And then I'll get the sample variance, and then you can round it to however many decimal